Yeah.
Welcome back to this week's episode of Trapping TV. This week we're going to focus on otter trapping. We traveled the country, a bunch of different states you're going to see, a bunch of different trapping methods, a bunch of different locations, rivers, lakes, streams, sloughs. So we're going to head right away to North Carolina and check out Brandon.
We just pulled up to the first location. We got some otter sets here and a few coon cuffs. We're running a whole different part today. We got a big mill pond set up and a whole river system up there. It's a big marsh. So hopefully we have a pretty good day. It's pretty cold last night. Probably the coldest night I've had down here. It's gotten the teens. Everything's all iced up, so the beavers probably didn't move too good, but we should still have some fur. So let's go check some traps.
Oh yeah, right here. First chick we just got out of the truck, we got an otter. This is the first time we just got permission on this spot a couple days ago and we got it set up.
Got an otter right here.
You gotta love starting the morning with an otter. This spot that we have here, it's just a little place, but there's not many fish farms down here. There's one of the only fish farms I know of right up the road. This guy owns right up to it, so I knew there wasn't much otter sign here, but I knew they'd be coming through here because there's a big river there and those fish ponds, so this is just a travel way for them. It's hopefully a family group came through. We're going to go check some more traps.
Start over.
Got a pipe right here. Two big sloughs come together, just a bunch of big flooded timber. There was no crossover here, so we knew they were going through the pipe. There's kind of like a little beaver dam inside this pipe. That side, I got it on the crossover. This side, I just had 330 submerged dive pole. Dive pole's sideways right now, and the water's pulled out a little bit, so let's see what we got. Blocked this down too, just to make sure that they weren't trying to use the side. And I see fur. It looks like an otter.
Oh yeah.
Big old otter.
Nice.
He's coming through this way.
Got him. Nice male.
These males, they're moving right now. Rut starting. So we got the traps out for him there. Picking them up. Right here, there's the main beaver dam over there. This is just flooded timber in here. It's all spread out. It's pretty hard to set up, but I got right here, I just pretty much have a Hail Mary set, just block this down. It's just a straight blind set, just right in the timber here. It's a good choice to pick here, but they could go, as you can see, this flooded timber, they could go many different routes. You can't fence them all down or put a trap in them, so I just picked this and put it in this and get out of it. Set off. Oh, yeah, got an otter. See the male floating right there. Gotta love when you see an otter too. Not the biggest one, but we'll take him.
Here we are, another location. Got a nice otter, great way to start the day off. Need a little bit of kick in here. Big otter. Get my tongs. These cable extensions, I think, are almost a pain. This trap has a circle trigger. The otter actually is inside the circle. You can see on the wire. I'll show a little bit on the circle trigger here in a minute when I reset it. As trappers, you never know what you might pull up out of a trap. When the water starts to rise and all sorts of different critters run.
Look for our wire.
We got about a 7-pound rattle. Prehistoric looking fish. He's still alive. We'll try some catch and release. We're setting some beaver and otter traps. We're at a different place. I haven't seen this particular area in about probably 5 or 6 years. We've been doing a lot of cold rolling here lately. All the frozen swamps and stuff behind us has really put a hamper on what we normally do. So we're just out hunting, basically. And we came across this, and what we're doing, you've got a main creek behind me, and you've got a beaver swamp up here, and there's all these little feeder creeks, and we're gonna keep this Forrest Gump simple. Every one of these feeder creeks is getting traps in it, some of them more than one. I don't want to spend a lot of time on any of them. They're so narrow, they're so perfect for what we're doing. Don't overcomplicate things. I'm going to hook up my extension cable to that tree. Normally, I'll tell you guys, I would rather put footholds in this than I would with a body grip trap. If you can probably hear through the background of that mic, we've got dogs right over there, we've got dogs right over there, and when I start putting footholds out, I've got to really worry about that. So sometimes, even though it's easy to say, well, they should keep their dogs on the leash, I don't want the headache. So I can put these type sets in, and I can actually go to bed tonight and not have to worry about a dog. Set this right in here. And I don't like that. Okay, I thought that water was deeper. Okay, that's gonna change the trigger configuration. I thought I could have those triggers. They'd be underwater and they're not. And I don't want to give that otter half the trap to jump through because it will. We saw an otter track just right up here, so we know they're here. They tore down a beaver dam under this train trestle right over there, so we know there's beaver in the area. My trap a little bit from people and critters. As I can without getting crazy for it. That's all we got to do. That's it. We're just going to repeat and wash, repeat and wash. Sometimes when you find situations like this, it's a godsend because it's so easy to control everything, set them up, get back in your vehicle and go find another one.
Well, back here at this location, it's a creek that just winds in and out like crazy. It's just big S's everywhere. Well, the otter they're making shortcuts. Like they come down this run and there's a shortcut over to the creek over there. Well, there's a good otter slide right there. If you could see that in the camera straight across the river. There was a trap down there in the water. And if you could see in the water there, there's Mr. Otter. His tail sticking out there. So then the other interesting thing is gonna be is there's a trap on the other slide going down the other side. So we're gonna get over there now and see what's on that, if there's anything. But at least we got one. That's a good day. Well, this big crossover here just goes from one side down the other. We got a double. I'm pretty sure that one's an otter, but I see an animal down it, and I'm gonna pull it up. Come take a look. This slide set here down by the water, the base of the water. Take this one out and we'll jump onto the other side and pull that one up.
Well, here's Mike's second otter. He's remaking that set and I'm gonna get this one started. That way we can move on. We got a huge line out down here. And with the two of us, scar on that guy. Helping one another out. We keep piling the fur up. Nice otter. Reservoir, we're on the levee, dam, have a faint crossover over here. We set it another day. We have a big otter. I already went down and looked at it, but I'll just show you the simply of the set. Big old dog, down there, otter. Him out for a remake.
Yeah. Came right up here, got this crossover right here, got a nice otter right there in this set. We're pulling this place today. We've taken, I think this makes number 9 out of here, so we don't really want to take any more. Good set right here. I've been a hot crossover this year.
Water came way up. Break the ice. Oh, we got an otter. Look at that. This trap sat here for 2 weeks. I decided to pull it. There's an otter in the trap. Look at that. Oh, yay. That makes for a good day. I just fell in the water, trying to break the ice, soaking wet, irritated. That made me happy. Oh, yay! This is the location we just pulled the otter out of the set. We had a huge rain last night. Water came up by 8 inches, but I want to reset the trap because it's a good spot. We got these puke piles right here, and then it's a old beaver dam that's broke out here. Well, there's a little run under this stick here. It's gonna be kind of deep for me. I might get a little wet, but it's worth it. It might be a little cold. That's all right. You can see this run's about knee deep. Set the trap.
all this is, it's this feeder creek off of a river, and it's just a pinch point right here. That's what I look for down through here. Anywhere that you can pinch the otter down if they're gonna stay in the water. Got my stabilizer sticks. Try to feel the hard part of the run. There's gonna be a spot in it that's gonna have like a little bowl in it for the most part. I'm gonna set the trap right in the center of that. I have a natural dive log here already. Now, I've otter trapped quite a few states now. It seems like the Ohio otter are just slick. They're kind of tough to catch. There's just not as many, I think, is the reason they're tough to catch. But my stabilizer sticks, usually it doesn't matter, but I try to push them down to below the water just so the otter doesn't see anything. It looks like there's nothing there. Well, then I also try to block it off a little bit. It's blocked off pretty well on this side. Great, there's a log under the water, but on this side it's kind of open. I'm gonna take some sticks, put them there like it's something that can come down in the high water. I took some saplings, the tops of them, that are brushy, and I closed this side off. I try to find brush that's close or something like this that looks natural. I mean, that looks like it's part of this, just flooded. So an otter, they can be tricky sometimes, especially if you get a smart one and you want to make it look like there's no trap there. So hopefully we can come back and have another one.
Oh, spring's off right here. Nothing in that one. Oh man, missed something here. This trap sprung. What we got here is we got this little branch that goes to the old beaver swamp up there where we just caught the coon and the mouse. And there was an old beaver dam here. It's not here anymore, so we just necked down three 330s. Nothing in that one. That one sprung, and we got one four trap right here. Let's see if we got anything here. Oh, got an otter right here. He was coming downstream, it looks like. Nice one. Right there. Another male. These males right now, they're cruising. They're looking for females. We're waiting for them at 3:30s. We're going to reset this and wait for some more to come through.
Thanks for joining us on this episode of Trapping TV. Next week we're going to do a continuation on our otter trapping. We're going to get in a little more detail about location. We're going to have special guest Joey Van Dyke. He's got a great otter line he does every year over on the coastal waters of North Carolina. Stay tuned for next week.